raised with an amazing legacy to model my life after. My grandparents were business owners in the community of Ohio that I grew up in. They were always invested in the interests of their employees, and they were heavily involved in the community. They showed me what being truly involved and what quiet leadership really looks like. Such was the difference that they made in our community that even after they both had passed, a group of their old employees wrote a letter to the newspaper celebrating the legacy that they left behind. And I hang that letter in my office today as an inspiration. So remember how I said I knew the words I wanted to say today would come to me? Now on Sunday, I still had no idea what I was going to say. You can ask Caitlin. But I took a few minutes to spend with my daughter to help her find just the right earrings to wear for homecoming this weekend. And as I was doing that, I pulled out that jewelry drawer that we have that has the old earrings, you know, from prom that we think maybe someday we might use again. And as I did, I discovered something that I had tucked away years and years ago. I pulled it out, and realizing what it was and remembering it, I sat down and I read it. It was so well written and so poignant that I made my family come sit down as I read these four typewritten pages out loud to them. And I'd like to share today with you just a couple of paragraphs of this amazing speech that was written by the same woman that I was just speaking of, my grandmother, and the words that she shared at her valedictorian speech when she graduated high school in 1931. One morning, just as a new day was breaking, each of two individuals had a new idea. One idly remarked, "But I can't complete it." And his idea died before noon, and the world lost a valuable invention. The other resolved to try out his new plot, and if not practical, give it to the world. These two decisions resulted in obscurity for one and fame for the other. So it is then with all great inventions and discoveries, they started with an idea and with a person who was determined to make the most of his opportunities. Present-day history is filled with the names of persons who, by developing their ideas and watching for opportunities, have been of service to the world. A fortunate few will be recorded in history, but that honor can neither equal nor surpass the feelings of those who have succeeded and learned that a task well done gives the greatest satisfaction that anyone can experience. Each of these pages are filled with such insight, and they resonate even today. The words of an 18-year-old, my grandmother, Ruth Schreiner, in 1931, embody what I hope to model my life after and what the YWCA bases their vision upon. In her closing words, "We have come now to the parting of ways. No longer will we be told to study certain lessons, but rather we shall now learn the larger lessons of life. Although there are always those who say, young people no longer have good chances. The great things have all been accomplished. There is no room for me. But there is always room at the top. The world is looking for persons who do their work well and who really want to succeed." So I started out planning to talk to you today about legacy, but the word that ended up standing out to me is the name of the poem she wrote, and she closes with success. Success is speaking words of praise and cheering other people's ways, and doing just the best you can with every task and every plan. It's silence when your speech would hurt, politeness when your neighbors hurt. It's deafness when the scandal flows, and sympathy in others' woes. It's loyalty when duty calls, its courage when disaster calls, its patience when the hours are long, it's found in laughter and in song. It's in a silent time of prayer and in happiness and despair. In all of life and nothing less, we find that thing we call success. The YWCA is about empowering women and making sure they have a voice to not just make a difference in our community, but in our world. Thank you again for this honor. I'm privileged to be among this group of amazing women.